Welcome to the Academy, a series focused on the basics of Star Wars The Old Republic.
Eternity Vault is the first operation players could play in Star Wars The Old Republic. While this operation is considered quite easy, and you'll probably be fine to just jump right in without a guide, this video will go over all the details of this operation so you know exactly what you're getting into. SOA is the final fight in this operation, and also one of the most cinematic fights in the entire game. Although the operation is considered easy when it comes to damage, you can still very easily get yourself killed in this fight, and the goal will be to keep yourself alive long enough to see the whole thing. Once you finish the council fight and you start running forwards through that hallway there, be careful not to run too far forwards or you will accidentally start the fight. Most teams will tell you to jump down the little ledge from the hallway onto the circular platform that SOA is on, but not to walk forward any closer to the boss. Unfortunately, there is a nasty bug that sometimes starts the fight if any player jumps down off the first ledge onto the round circle platform. If you want to avoid this, stay up on the smaller ledge until you're ready to start. When it comes to positioning, the ranged players and healers will want to stay as far back from SOA as possible, and stand near to the door and ledge where they entered the room, on the outer ring of the circular platform. The close range players will want to attack SOA close up, but try and stay as close to where they entered as possible, so don't run through or behind the boss. You'll need to run back to where you originally started, near the entrance, fairly soon. So keep this in mind when moving forward to attack SOA. If you get disoriented, look at the map, as the entrance is to the west, or the left side, of the map. When the fight actually starts, SOA will have a glowing orange shield up, and you can't damage him while the shield is visible and he's awakening. Pretty quickly, SOA will place down large green puddles on the ground that harm anyone standing in them. If a puddle shows up where you are standing, move out of it, but keep in mind that you'll need to run back to the outer ring near the entrance very soon. When SOA goes down from 100% health to 75%, SOA will shield up and say, "I have waited 20,000 years, but I will wait no longer," and the ground will start shaking. This is a sign that the middle rings of the circular platform are about to fall away, and the team needs to get back quickly to the outer ring near the entrance, which will soon become a ledge with a sheer drop all around it. If you aren't on the correct ledge after the floor falls, you'll either plummet to your death or be stuck on a ledge in the middle of nowhere, away from your group. If you're a close range player, you may want to start moving away from SOA and back towards the entrance at around 80% health, and let the ranged player shoot him from far away for the last few percent. The goal will be to carefully jump down the ledges as they appear and reach the next floor with your group. Once the floor falls away, you should be safe to jump one ledge down from the ledge you started on. On this platform, you will wait. Hold. Every time you jump down a platform, you take damage. And if you jump down at full speed, there's a good chance you'll get yourself killed. If you jump down to a third nearby platform right away off the side, it's a very long drop, and you won't be giving your healer a good chance to heal you with the group. Instead, if you're patient, another platform will appear behind the second ledge that is a much less steep drop, and your team will carefully jump down to it, and to multiple other platforms, attacking the yellow enemies you see along the way. If you have healing abilities, heal yourself as you drop down. When you reach a natural point, where there is no more ledges to jump to yet, group up with your team and stack up for heals, and help heal your teammates if you happen to have any healing abilities at all, since there are no enemies nearby to attack anyway. Soon, another ledge will appear and you'll be able to continue down. At any point, if you're extremely close to death, don't jump down off the side of the ledge. Instead, heal yourself, or give your healer a chance to find and heal you. Once you reach the floor, stack up for heals again, and wait for the boss to arrive. On the way down, there will be small, yellow-named pylons on the ledges and platforms as you jump down that need to be destroyed along the way. Most groups will simply have the group destroy them as they go, with everyone getting a few shots in on the pylons as they're running. But unfortunately, there's a bug that can cause the pylon destruction benefit to not apply and take place, making the fight harder. To avoid this bug, Your team should not destroy the pylons as a team, and instead, no one touches the pylons while jumping down except for one single designated damage-based player who will kill them all by themselves. If you're not in an organized team, though, you probably won't be able to assign a single player and make everyone stick to it, so just go ahead and pew-pew those pylons along the way. On the middle floor, a fun new mechanic is introduced called Mind Traps. A random member of your team will be sucked into the mind trap and won't be able to help with the fight until they're freed. To free your teammate, attack the glowing blue mind trap pyramids as soon as they appear. Pretty much top priority. Soa also likes to assign lightning orbs to players randomly in the group. When the orb reaches you, it will explode, hurting everyone nearby, and it also zaps anyone it comes near to with lightning as it's traveling on its way over to find you. You can help your team by looking for it and running over to your orb when you see your name show up in red text on the screen, and explode your lightning orb by running into it when none of your teammates are nearby. In Story Mode Eternity Vault, one lightning orb will appear, and in Veteran Mode, two will appear for two different players. Teams will often call out the names of players who need to go find their lightning orbs out in voice chat. There's also another fun mechanic introduced in this phase where Soa will pick a random team member to hurl into the air, causing them to fly around. If this happens to you, just enjoy the ride. You'll wind up on the opposite side of the room where you'll want to wind up. So make sure to orient yourself when you land. At 29% health, Soa will shield up again and say, again, "I have waited 20,000 years, but I will wait no longer." And then the middle of the platform will drop away again. You'll want to be in the same safe position as last time, which will be west or on the left side of the map, on the outside ring of the platform, or you'll fall to your death when the platform crumbles. If you're a close range or melee player, you might want to get moving at around 35%, especially as you may have been running around, jumping between Soa, the mine traps, and looking for your lightning. Much like the ledges before, stick with your group, and don't jump if you're too low health to survive the fall. On the final floor, Soa will put up a shield, and can't take any damage unless the shield is removed. To destroy the shield, your tank will need to bring Soa to under a pyramid that will float into the air. On Story Mode Eternity Vault, the location where the pillar will fall is marked with a glowing blue circle. But in Veteran Mode, players will need to guess where it will fall based on its shadow and its location in the air. If Soa is correctly hit with the falling pillar, he will crouch down and become vulnerable to attacks. When this happens, all players on your team will want to focus on attacking Soa at full force, ignoring any mind traps or lightning orbs until Soa has reshielded. When the pyramid falls, there's also sometimes a knockback, so players, especially the tank, will want to position themselves so that they are not flung back into the lava around the edge of the platform. The pillar itself also really hurts if it gets dropped on you, so avoid it when possible. While Soa is shielded in between those pyramids knocking him down, players will want to focus on the mind traps and lightning orbs and help the tank position the boss as best that they can. There is another bug I wanted to talk about for Soa specifically. If one of your team members dies during the fight, especially while jumping down, and finds out they can't revive even after the battle is over, have them return to area start. Ride the speeder, run back to the final fight room, and then jump and fall to their death down below where you are. Your team can then revive them, and they can get their reward from the boss. If the team has not looted yet, and the team does not loot, they can instead return to Med Center, run back into the operation, and they'll be able to loot the boss, but don't do this unless your whole team knows to wait and loot the boss. As I mentioned at the very beginning, this is really one of the easier and friendlier operations to go into, so don't let any of this intimidate you, and hop right in if you happen to see a group forming for Eternity Vault, either on Story Mode or the harder Veteran Mode. If you want to show your support for this series, or to have similar Star Wars The Old Republic videos on all topics show up on your YouTube homepage, subscribe to this channel. And if you want to help ensure the future of these Star Wars The Old Republic in-depth guides, visit Swtorista.com/support to make a pledge to this project. May the Force be with you.